Hello, Inventor. So in this video, I'm going to show you how we can create the Flying Dino game using MIT App Inventor. So here we go. So click on New Project, and my project name is Dino Flying Game. Okay, and click on OK. This is our first screen, blank screen. Now, we need to create our three screens, okay? So for that, I'm going to use your layouts. First, for the play game. Second screen for the main screen, and third is our game over screen. So I'm going to just click on the layout and just drag and drop the vertical arrangement like this and make this within height is fill parent like this. Okay. And make this vertical arrangement. So like game start vertical arrangement layout. Okay. And okay. Now I'm going to just copy paste two times. Just control C or command C or command V like this. Now we have three layouts. Second layout, I'm going to just make this is a main layout. So game is like main screen, and then this is the vertical arrangement. So just use here vertical arrangement layout. Okay. And then click on okay. So this is the main screen. Third one is our game over screen. So rename this also and just say here game over VA vertical arrangement layout like this. So now we have three layouts. Okay. So let's work on the first one. So I'm going to just hide this one visible, make it off like this and make it like this. And this is our layout first. Okay. This is our first screen. So I'm going to drag and drop here one button. So you click on user interface and just drag and drop one button here and make that button in the bottom. So click on the this layout and make this horizontal should be centered, and then vertical should be bottom like this. But I need that button somewhere like this. So I'm going to use here one label, like just drag and drop, not image, label like this here, and make that label blank like this. And just click on the hide and make this hide is like 30% or make it 20%. So our button is here, and just click on that button text and just say our start game. This is our button. Make this shape like rounded like this. Make it font is like around 30. And let's make it 24. Let's click on the background color. So I'm going to use your other color plates. So I'm going to use this color plate. Like let's copy this code. I might happen when to go to the background color of that button. Change this to something like this. Change the text color. So I'm going to just make it this one as a text. And just change the text color like custom and paste it like this. Okay, this is the start game. I'm going to add the background image of that layout. So click on layout. You will see here the option of image. Click on this. Click on upload file and click on choose file. So I already have one image. Okay, so this is the Dino game. And you can see here I have one image. Just make sure don't upload the very high resolution images. Okay, click on open and just okay. So this is our start game. Now, what you can do here, you can just change that button color also, but because this is not matching to our image. So I'm going to just make that color plate. Go here and try this one. Go to the custom and change the background color like this. Okay, like this. Now, this is a start game. This is one screen. Okay, now make sure you click on the screen and change that name is like Flying Dino Game like this. Okay, title this. Now I'm going to just hide this because this screen is completed. Okay. Now just visual off. And I'm going to just work on the game over screen for now. Let's visual it. Done. Now game over layout, I need one more background image for that. So I'm going to just click on the image option. Click on the upload file. Click on the choose file. And you can see I have one image for the game over. This one. Okay. I'm going to just upload that game over screen here like this. Now I need to add one button here. So just drag and drop one button like this. And the same thing we need to do for this also, like make it center, make it in the bottom, and use one label or something to make this button in the upper, like just remove the text from the label and make this height is like 20%. And you can just change that button text to something like replay or game over something. Replay, okay, like this, and make it 24 like this. And change the background color like this, your color, and edit here like this. So this is our replay button. Okay. So we have created two screens here. The first one is the game start and then another one is the game over. Okay, now let's make it visual off also. Now go to the main screen and make it enable. This is our main game screen. Okay, now first of all, I'm going to add here two layouts. Okay, in the left side, we find the layout and just drag and drop the horizontal scroll arrangement. First one, that is important because we need to use here the, you know, scroll background for that. First one, this is the layout. Another, I'm going to use here the horizontal arrangement for the buttons like this. Okay, so let's make this horizontal arrangement to the fill parent like this. And this one horizontal scroll arrangement should be height fill parent. And the width is also fill parent like this. And click on this horizontal arrangement and make sure the height is like, 20% or something like this. Now click on user interface and just drag and drop here some buttons like first. Okay, and just change that name, change that button color to something custom and make that color is like this. And just change the text color white, make that font bold, and then change the font size to around 18 or 20 something, and change that text to like up, okay, because we need to use your two buttons, okay, up, down, and the sound button. So I'm gonna make that width is like 20% is fine. Let's try. Yeah, just copy and paste three times. First one up, second one for the down like this, and third one is for the sound, like sound like this. Make all these buttons in a center like this, align center, and this is center like this. Now what you can do here, see this is the 20% not working, so I'm gonna just make it to the 30% like this. Cool, done. Now we have these buttons here. Now I'm gonna just change the background color of that horizontal arrangement to the black like this. Now we have this horizontal scroll arrangement here. Now we need to add the canvas. In the left side, you will find the drawing animation. Just drag and drop the canvas like this and make that canvas height and width is fill parent like this. Okay, now this is our main screen of our game. Okay, where we are gonna play the game. So we need here two image sprite. First one, go to the drawing animation. This is image sprite, drag and drop one image. That is our hero, that is our main character, okay? And one more image I need to use here, this is the something, you know, second image for evil. So this evil is like something like, we need to make sure that should not touch the our main character or otherwise our game will over, okay? So how we can do this? So it's simple. So first of all, I'm gonna add here the one first character. So click on image sprite one and click on the image option here, this one picture option. Click on the upload file, click on the choose file. So I already have one, my hero is that cute, dinosaur. So I'm gonna just open this file and click on OK. Now make sure we need to make that image sprite width and height is like, let's try 100 pixel and let's see how this will work with the 100 pixel width and height. And it's good, okay. You can increase the size or decrease the size according to you. Now I'm gonna just make that image sprite 2 also the width and height is 100 pixel. Like this, and height is also 100 pixel like this. Now I need to add here the one evil also. So click on image sprite 2, click on the picture, click on the upload file, click on choose file, and you will see here I have one images, one more is this one. Okay, this is the evil that I'm gonna just add on here, this one. Cool. Now we have two characters in our game. Now we need to add the background, okay, so because we need to move our background also, like we need to do the something like Mario or something like that we use the play like Dino game, okay. So how we can add the background and images? So I have created one image and the canva, so you can also do it like this. So what do you need to do here? Go to the canva, here the canva, in this canva click on the custom size and make sure the width should be 8000 pixel and the height is around 500 pixel, okay. 8000 is too long, so we can have the, you know, background, okay, long background. So click on the create new design and here is our this is the that will look like this. So what I need to do here, we need to add some images here. So let's go to the, you know, you can just choose the that element like this here, this, or you can just go to the image here directly. or you can use this one or otherwise it's fine totally. Now I'm just gonna drag and drop any image here like this, okay? And you can use any images here, okay? Some of the images are like pro or some are the like no without pro, like this one also, okay? Or try to use some image that will feel like the, you know, the background is like suppose the sunrise or sunset or something, okay? Sunrise or sunset, let's try sunset, right? Okay, like this. So I'm gonna just use this one picture, suppose this one, okay? I'm gonna use the picture like this, or try to do add some picture that can be like this. See, this is amazing. Cool. Now what we need to do here, we need to click on the elements like this, and we need to add, you know, some mountains, like open the mountains like this, and we need to add like this. See, we have a lot of mountains, so you can use some free components. There are a lot of bad components also. See the free components here. So I just added the mountain here and just drag and drop that mountain in the bottom like this. See, can you see that this one mountain? Like just, you can just copy paste this 2-3 times and add multiple location, okay, like this, okay, here. You can add a lot more, you know, like this. See this one, like this you can do, okay. You have multiple options, like you can add the trees also, like see this, these are the trees you can add. So you can make your own background like this. See, cool, amazing. So we need to just download that image from here, like click on share and you can see the download option like this, and just download this image, this dino game. And I have the background image to background image. Let me just open this. See, this one, first one is here, this one, and second one is the night one image. First one is the, you know, day image, and second one is the night image I have created, okay? Simple. So let's go to the MIT App Inventor here, okay? And let's click on the canvas and make sure click on the background image and upload file. Click on choose file, and we have the one image is 1.png. That one, just open this. So it will take some more seconds. Yeah, done, I think. Yeah, see, look like this will look like this. So make sure you don't need to worry about that. That will be perfect. Okay, so don't worry about that. So what I'm going to do, I'm not going to just click on the width is like automatic. Make it like this. Okay, just done. Now let's do one thing, because see, once I just you know, select that image, you can see that I can drag my image like this. See now, so I need to move my image in the left to right like this. Okay, so how can I do this? So open a new tab. Type here ai.coling3.cn. This is the website. Okay, so we just need to just open that website here, and we need to use the choose language is English. And you can see here, we need to use extension. Click on the Mac extension and you will see the scroll arrangement extension. Okay, where it is scroll, just type search here, scroll. See, scroll arrangement handler, click on this and just drag and drop, and you will just scroll down and you will see the download button. Click on the mirror of the website and we have downloaded the AIX file. Okay, I will give you the link of this extension in the description, okay? Go to the MIT App Inventor. In the left side is the extension. Click on import extension. Click on choose file. And the download, you will see this AIX file. Just open this and import. We are using this extension to scroll our that background. Okay. Okay. Now you can see horizontal scroll handle. Just drag and drop this. Okay. Now what we need to do, we need to use your timer. In the left side, you'll find the sensor. And you will see the clock. So just drag and drop one clock, and I need to use two clock like this. So we have the clock that will define the, you know, character, how we need to, you know, display them. Okay. And this horizontal scroll will, you know, just scroll that overall background. And we have added almost complete design. So I'm going to just do the code for this. I'm going to do first code is like, that is the main screen design is completed. Okay. Now, first we need to code for that game start layout. So once I click on that play button, like this button, so I need to display that main screen. Okay, so this is the first part of our game that we have completed the design. In the next part, we will learn how we can do the block coding. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to the channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.